In previous lecture, I already discussed what is minimal element and maximal element, what is greatest element and least element. Today, I will discuss what is upper bound and lower bound. Sometimes, it is possible to find an element that is greater than or equals to all the element in the subset A of set. If U is an element of S such that A is less than equals to U for all A belongs to A, then U is called an upper bound of A. If there is an element U that is greater than or equals to all other element, it's called as upper bound. In the same way, there can be lower bound. If an element is less than or equals to all other element, it's called as lower bound. If L is an element of S such that L less than equals to A for all A belongs to A, then L is called as lower bound of A. There can be multiple upper bound and lower bound. Upper bound we can write as U, lower bound we can write as L. Let's see one example. Example 15, find the lower and upper bound of the subset ABC, JH, ACDF in the post set with the histogram shown in the figure. This is the histogram. We need to find upper bound and lower bound for these subsets. First, we'll find for ABC. ABC. Now, for ABC, its upper bound can be E, F, not D. D cannot be upper bound of C, right? So, the element which can be upper bound of all three, A, B, C, it can be E, F, J, H. So, there can be four upper bound like E, F, J, H. And its lower bound can be A only. And from the upper bound, lowest upper bound called as least upper bound. So, here there are four upper bound E, F, J, H. We can say E as least upper bound. Next, we'll check for JH. J is here, H is here. It don't have any upper bound, but its lower bound can be F as F. So, it can be E, it can be D, it can be B, it can be A and C. So, for JH, its lower bound can be A, B, C, D, F and have no upper bound. And if it will ask greatest lower bound, so F will be its greatest lower bound. So it have multiple lower bound like A, B, C, D, E, F, but not J, right? And no upper bound. Next we'll check for A, C, D, F. For A, C, D, F, its upper bound will be J, then H, but not G. So its upper bound can be F, J, H. And its lower bound can be A. If it will ask its least upper bound, it will be F. And greatest lower bound, it will be A. So next I will discuss what is greatest lower bound and what is least upper bound. So the element X is called as least upper bound of the subset A if X is an upper bound that is less than every other upper bound of A. If there is an upper bound which is less than all other upper bound, it's called as least upper bound. So that is X is a least upper bound of A if A is less than X for all A belongs to A and there is a Z such that Z is an upper bound and Z is greater than equals to X. Same way there can be greatest lower bound. So an element Y called the greatest lower bound of A if Y is lower bound of A means there are some lower bound Z which are less than Y. So greatest lower bound and least upper bound are unique whereas there can be multiple lower bound and multiple upper bound. We can write greatest lower bound as GLB and least upper bound as LUB. So LUB stands for least upper bound. GLB stands for greatest lower bound. Now one example, example 16, find the greatest lower bound and least upper bound of BDG if it exists in the post shown in figure. Figure is same as previous example. So we need to find GLB and LUB for BDG. For BDG, its upper bound are G and H. Now from G and H, G is the lowest. So we can say least upper bound is G and its lower bound are B and A. From B and A, B is highest. So we can say B is the greatest lower bound. So here B is the greatest lower bound and G is the least upper bound. Next, example 17, find the greatest lower bound and least upper bound of the set 3, 9, 12 and 1, 2, 4, 5, 10 if they exist in the poset Z plus and relation is division. So we need to find for 3, 9, 12 and 1, 2, 4, 5, 10. So let me create first a hash diagram for 3, 9, 12. 3 is divisible by 9, 3 is divisible by 12. This is a subset, right? So there can be multiple number. So let for 9 and 12. So 9, 12 both are divisible by 36. And 3 is divisible by 1. So here just given this 3, 9, 12 a subset. I'm just drawing some other part like 1 and 36. I'm just adding 1 and 36. Okay. So now lower bound for 3, 9, 12 will be 1 and 3. From these 3 is higher. So 3 will be greatest lower bound and its least upper bound will be 36. Now for the other subset contain 1. 1 is divisible by 2, 2 is divisible by 4, then 5. 5 is divisible by 1. Then 10, 10 is divisible by 5, also 10 is divisible by 2. And this is the subset. Now I'm adding some more elements like 4, 10, both are divisible by 20. So 20 I'm adding, right? This is the subset. For 1, 2, 4, 5, 10, its greatest lower bound is 1 and least upper bound is 20. 20 is divisible by both 4 and 10. In today's lecture, I discussed what is upper bound, what is lower bound, how to find greatest lower bound and least upper bound. In next lecture, I will discuss lattice. If this lecture is helpful for you, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you.